come on the field. Meanwhile, the K-State Wildcats are 5-2, need a win today to become bowl eligible. Now, with our Hass Avocado kickoff, let's go down to Emily Jones.
Well, guys, it is Halloween. I'm hanging out with Gandalf the Purple. He's got two messages. One is for Oklahoma State, thou shalt not pass. The other is for you at home. He wants to tell you that it's time to get your football party started with Hass Avocados. Fresh, creamy Hass Avocados. Nothing else will do, says Gandalf the Purple, guys.
Homecoming and folks in full spirit here in Manhattan. Thank you very much, Emily. As Anthony Cantelli, a sophomore from Wichita, Kansas, will kick it off for Kansas State. Wildcats won the coin toss. They deferred at Oklahoma State to receive with Thomas and Randall, the deep players. And Joseph Randall fumbles it in the end zone and then is taking the great advice to just take a knee there and bring it out to the 20. And let's take a look at our Phillips Television starting lineup. First of all, for Oklahoma State and the offensive line, a group that has been very solid, putting up some unbelievable numbers this year. They don't always get all the credit. And keep an eye on those backs and receivers. Cooper, the leader now that Blackman is out. And, of course, the quarterback is junior Brandon Whedon, 6'4", 219 from Edmond, Oklahoma, and has thrown for 21 touchdowns already. Randall and Hunter in the backfield. Whedon tosses this one out. And complete to the 30. Randall still spinning and near the 32-yard line. He's got a first down. Now let's take a Phillips Television's defensive lineup for the Kansas State Wildcats. They have been giving up a total of 25.9 points per game. They're playing a 4-2-5 today. Keep an eye on Garrett. He is a big hitter there in the secondary. Hunter tackled at the 35-yard line. A loss on the play, and Ty Zimmerman making the stop. The freshman from Junction City, Kansas, for Kansas State.
You know, it's interesting. Oklahoma State comes right out and throws a screen pass. You know, when you look at it, the third leading receiver on the football team, Joseph Randall, out of the backfield. The backs are going to be involved in the passing game more today with Blackman out.
Whedon, plenty of time, quick release, complete.
Juggled it.
Nope. Out of bounds as he juggled the football. Sweeney was covering on the play, and the receiver on the play was Shelf. Colton Shelf.
Yeah, and this was a catchable football. I mean, he put it right on the money, and you got to catch that football. He doesn't have possession. He has both feet in bounds, but he's juggling it. No possession, no catch. Got to squeeze the pig.
And as a result, it's a third down and 12 to go. Hunter goes in motion. Whedon complete at the 43, and diving and getting the first down would be Bowling, as Zimmerman was covering on the play. The extra effort, yards after catch for Bo Bowling.
Absolutely. Big time yak action. And watch, Bowling runs the pattern to the sideline, catch, knows where he is, good awareness, field awareness, make a couple of tackles miss, know where you have to get, extends the football over the chains. Move him on third and 12. Big conversion.
He picked up 14 and a first to 10 near midfield. And Hunter right up the middle across the 45 and nearly broke it. It goes to the end zone because he had a huge hole. Zimmerman and Hartman, the stoppers.
Well, nice job by Hunter. Look, a little trap, and Hunter just takes it right up the football field, north and south. And he'll run through arm tackles. He's 5'8", but he's over 200 pounds. He does not give you a whole lot of hitting surface. It's like trying to hit a pectoral and a quadricep.
You see the numbers on Hunter this year. First in the Big 12, third nationally in yards per game. This one a completion to, well, I beg your pardon, as he couldn't hang on, is to Bowling, and Rebeck covering in the play in the secondary, the linebacker for Kansas State.
Boy, receivers aren't doing Whedon any favors early in this football game. That's two drops in my mind. Whedon has been on the money. He has been extremely accurate. You got to catch that football. It's right there for you. He's trying to distribute to everybody. You got to reward him with a catch when he throws it that perfectly.
Third and two for the Cowboys on the opening possession for Oklahoma State. And Hunter. Oh, great tackle that time. Ty Zimmerman. Hunter tried to dance it to the outside, and Zimmerman wrapped him up.
These safeties are all big. Zimmerman, 6'1", 203 pounds. I mean, they've got 6'3" and 6'4" safeties. And Zimmerman just makes the read and fills off the edge. Here he comes. Perfect tackle. Helmet across the bow. When you make a tackle on one-on-one in space on a running back of that caliber, that's big.
Keep an eye on special teams. It's going to be big today. This is the nation's top punter in Quinn Sharp, and he boots one perfectly inside the 5-yard line, goes out at the 4. So Oklahoma State gets a 41-yard kick from Sharp, and it's 1st and 10 at the 5. Now, a look at Phillips Television starting lineups for the Kansas State Wildcats and that big offensive front. Backs and receivers, of course, Thomas the leader there, and the quarterback is Kaufman, 6'3", 211, a senior. And Kaufman, typical is what you would expect with a Bill Snyder coach team, getting better and better each week. Last week, outstanding in their loss to the Baylor Bears. Completes it on a first down pass, trying to get a little breathing room. Lewis makes the tackle on the play. And let's take a look now. Phillips Television's providing the defensive front for the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Jarka, injured earlier in the year, a real leader. Ori Lemon leads the nation in solo tackles at the linebacker spot. And in the secondary, great leadership out of Markell Martin.
Well, Aubrey Qualls had a great block on that first down bubble screen. These wide receivers in the Big 12 stock block so well for their teammates on the edge.
Harper, the receiver, picked up 5 yards on the play. Second down and 5. Play action, and Daniel Thomas forges ahead to the 13-yard line where Ori Lemon makes the tackle.
Ori Lemon averaging over 8 yards per game. Eight tackles per game. That's amongst the best in the country. Ori Lemon is struggling right now, though. He is on the turf, and he's in a little bit of trouble. Man, that was strange. He got up after the play, but then just went to the turf, and now he's on his front side. He's in some agony right now.
Lemon, a senior out of Houston, Texas, from Yates High School, and just heard me comment that Bill Young, the defensive coordinator, just cannot say enough good things about Ori Lemon, not only his play, but his leadership with this defense.
Watch his left leg. He's going to get rolled up on and just rolls across the back. And that's the big fullback, Braden Wilson. That's what happens. You get in piles, and your body's not meant to bend like that unless you're Gumby. You know, your joints just aren't that flexible and bent the wrong way. And what a tragedy it would be, because he missed last season because of knee surgery, and he rehabilitated himself, has come back, and he's the leader of this defensive football team, and he gets caught up in a pile, and hopefully it just scared him more than anything else, and he didn't sustain any severe damage, because it would be tough for the defense to lose Ori Lemon.
Lemon, in his junior season, which was the 08 campaign, had 90 tackles and was all set for a huge year before he had the red shirt because of the knee injury last year, as Dave mentioned, and been playing terrific so far this season. Bill Young, defensive coordinator.
And Bill Young says that Ori Lemon's basically an extension of him on the field. I mean, he knows this defense cold. He knows where everybody's supposed to line up. He is the conductor out there of that defensive orchestra.
Cowboys coming off a loss to Nebraska last week, 51-41, and gave up some horrific numbers if you're a Cowboy fan, but Bill Young said our defense was a matter of maybe too jacked at times and trying to make the huge play instead of just good fundamental defense, and hoping they get back to that kind of play here today.
Wrap the arms when you tackle. Just don't try to knock them down.
Here's Taylor Martinez will do that too. And K-State on the ground. Loose football. Thomas.
Well, that's a heads-up play, a big recovery.
Mayfield, I think.
Yeah, right there to fall on the football, heads up. And, man, they're hitting, though. And that's what we were talking about. You want to have good, sure tackling. Puts the helmet right on the football. Daniel Thomas does not fumble the ball very often, but when the helmet hits right on the football like that, I mean, that's just an outstanding effort right there by Johnny Thomas. He was Johnny on the spot, separated Thomas from the football, running back Thomas. Thomas on Thomas.
1st and 10 at the 18 is Kansas State. Oh, there's another drop. Talked about OSU had a couple. This time, drop by Quarles.
Coaches talk about it all the time. Put your helmet on the football, and it'll cause turnovers. And Thomas couldn't do it any better. Johnny Thomas on Daniel Thomas. Bang! Helmet right on that football and knocks it out of there. That's picture perfect. That's coaching real stuff right there in terms of how you tackle and knock the football out of there.
Johnny Thomas, a junior out of Texas City, Texas, coming in with 32 tackles for the Cowboys. 2nd and 10, And again, the handoff here. Gent makes the tackle as Daniel Thomas is brought down at the 21-yard line.
Kansas State punched themselves out of bad field position inside the 5-yard line by making positive yards on first down. They stayed ahead of the chains, and they converted on third and short. And because of a fumble forward that was recovered, they were fortunate. Didn't get anything on this first down, though. Here they are, third and long behind the chains. First down success leads to third down success.
Kaufman threw for 231 and 20 of 29 in the Baylor loss. Also ran for a couple of scores. This one is complete, but tugging from behind to make the tackle for OSU was Gent. And he prevented the receiver from getting the first down. And as a result, Kansas State would kick it away. And they'll bring on Josh Cherry.
Very persistent by Gent. I mean, a little check down by Kaufman. He almost made a great play at the very end on the check down to move the chains.
Beg your pardon, that is Ryan Doerr with the punting. Doerr, sophomore from Katy, Texas. And it is caught at the 39 by Josh Cooper. And that's where Oklahoma State will take over on its second position. A 35-yard punt. You're watching Big 12 College Football Saturday.